In this video, I will be providing an overview of cardiac muscle. So let's begin with a question. Where is cardiac muscle found? The heart, right? Have you ever thought about the function of this muscle? In other words, why does the heart have to contract? To pump the blood, right? So is this cardiac muscle voluntary or involuntary? It's involuntary. Is it striated or not? It is striated. Remember, the only muscle that's not striated is smooth muscle. Okay, now for some details. Cardiac muscle has troponin and tropomyosin. Did we have troponin and tropomyosin in smooth muscle? No. And where is calcium released from when it comes to smooth muscle? Mostly the extracellular fluid, but some from the endoplasmic reticulum. This is the same for cardiac muscle. And now we'll talk about reuptake of calcium in cardiac muscle. This will sound familiar to you as well. Remember that both smooth and skeletal muscle have calcium ATPase in the endoplasmic reticulum. This is also true for cardiac muscle. What are the other two types of reuptake in smooth muscle? They are calcium ATPase on the sarcolemma and sodium calcium counter transport on the sarcolemma. Whether we're talking about where calcium is released from or how calcium is taken back up into the extracellular fluid or the endoplasmic reticulum, it's the same as smooth muscle. Cardiac muscle is myogenic. So if it's myogenic, is it going to have gap junctions? Absolutely. Cardiac muscle will also generate pacemaker potentials and cardiac potentials, which we will talk about later. What's this little area I have circled here on this diagram? It contains gap junctions, but it also contains desmosomes. So collectively, what do we call this area? An intercalated disk. Does this diagram here look somewhat familiar? We did this for smooth muscle. Now we are going to do the same for cardiac muscle. So if the parasympathetic nervous system predominates, what neurotransmitter is released from the preganglionic fiber? Acetylcholine. What's the name of the receptor on the postganglionic fiber? Nicotinic cholinergic. When the sympathetic nervous system predominates, what neurotransmitter is released from the preganglionic fiber? Acetylcholine. What's the name of the receptor on the postganglionic fiber? Nicotinic cholinergic. Now, let's look at the postganglionic fiber. So when the parasympathetic nervous system predominates, what neurotransmitter is released from the varicosity? Acetylcholine. What receptor is acetylcholine going to bind to on the effector? Muscarinic cholinergic. And what is the effector in this situation? Cardiac muscle. Then if the sympathetic nervous system dominates, what neurotransmitter gets released from the varicosities? Epinephrine. What is the name of the receptor on the effector? Adrenergic.